today we have an amazing presentation, and we've got myself, and everybody knows my business partner, Eric Sprague, and our marketing savant, Mr. Connor Klassen here, and he put all the backgrounds and everything together here, and he's going to present some cool skills for everybody as well. He's got some cool tactics that he's going to present. So before we get started, the best thing for everybody to do is to get a notepad out, pen, highlighter, everything that you possibly can, and stay focused. Take this phone of yours, put it on silent, turn it off if you can, and put it down, because I'm going to do the same thing. And I'm going to be paying attention, taking notes. If anybody has any questions, throw them in the chat. Focus on your computer. You know, if you're going to spend your time here, you might as well make it quality time, because there's a lot of content that's going to be thrown at you. And if you have questions, like I said, you can raise your hand. Hopefully Eric will slow down, but you can definitely throw them in the chat and I will get to them as fast as I can. Connor as well. And cool. We're having all kinds of cool people here that I haven't seen in a while. We got Ryan. How's it going, buddy? I just saw you at the core.
All right. Yeah, good to see you too.
Anyway, nice to see you too, my friend.
Thank you for the card in the mail.
Service? I'm sorry?
Thank you for the card in the mail. I got it over here.
A good picture of us, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was pretty funny. I liked it.
Yeah, there you go. Check that out, huh? Very cool. Right on. So I don't know what type of home services you guys have with you. Throw them in the comments if you can. Alex, don't even try because you're driving. And if you want to put your home service business in the
my weed from what's his name
in here, that'd be great. And any comments or questions, let us know. We got people coming in. Connor, I think it's almost your turn to take over.
All right.
And I will keep letting people in. And I'll let Eric be a co-host as well. And we will do our best to make this as smooth as silk. You've got the floor, my friend.
Well, yeah, let's get started then. So I just want to go over our agenda real quick. Because in the short time that we've got together today, we really want to make a big impact in your home service business in three major ways. The first thing that we want to do is we want to help you provide a deeper level of service to your customers. We want to give you a roadmap of your next steps, as well as cut through some of the BS and give you some real strategies that you can take away and use today. But if nothing else, if we do fail at all three of those things, we are at least here to show you how you can boost your profits on each job site. And I just lost my screen there. Tech issues. There we go. Can you guys still see my screen there?
You're all good.
Wonderful. All right. So this workshop is for a very specific, person. It's for a person who owns a blue collar home service company. If you've got at least three full-time employees, this is specifically for you. And if you want to become the go-to company in your area, your city, your county, your state, if that describes you, this should be specifically for you and you should be extra focused. But the thing is, we do need something from you before we can really get started. And that is, we need your implementation, because there's really going to be nothing worse for you than choosing to invest your time and energy into learning something new and then actively choosing to do nothing. In fact, if you do choose to do nothing, you may as well throw your own time in the trash, and that would kind of suck for you. So if you're the type of person who's not afraid to get in the trenches, you get stuff done, you're an implementer, just let us know in the chat. Give me a thumbs up. Let me know that you're the type of person that gets things done. Because I do think Howard Partridge says it best. He says, "I've come to realize that the number one reason people don't grow to the next level in their lives, career, or business is FTI, failure to implement." So is that fair enough? Is it fair of us not only to ask you to implement, but also me, Eric, and Larry, we expect you to implement what we cover today. And so I want to give you a little bit of the background. You guys probably know us. Larry's on the left there, Eric's on the right. I had the privilege of meeting both of them about 2 years ago at a live event in Florida, and it was one of the most pivotal meetings that I've ever had in my life. Eric and Larry owned a flood restoration and carpet cleaning business that they were able to build in such a way that they could sell it for over eight figures. And these days, they're helping home service businesses build companies that are stable, they're systemized, and they're highly profitable. They currently train over 600 home service teams around the world, and Eric speaks to thousands of business owners from stage every single year. So a while back, I sent them this email, and pretty much what it says is, I love what you're doing in the home service world. Can I join your team? Can I work with you guys? And so obviously, I was very excited when I got this message from Eric, and it says, Connor, we've got the add-on sales workshop coming up soon, and I want you to present. So I said, yeah, that's awesome. Yes, let's do it. And I'm going to bring Eric on in just a little bit, but I just really quickly want to go over the cool stuff that we're going to cover in this workshop, if that's okay. Because in today's workshop, we're going to be diving deep into the tactics of getting your technicians to sell your services. But before we can do that, we've got to lay the foundation to make those tactics as effective as they possibly can be. We're going to talk about why some businesses can deserve high prices, while others are stuck playing the game where they have to undercut their competition and their competition undercuts them and everyone races to the bottom and loses. We're going to give you a detailed breakdown of the simple framework that we use to get our technicians to sell services, and we're going to show you a simple and sustainable way to offer add-ons to your customers and get your technicians to sell. We're going to be selecting the most profitable services that you already sell that you can get your teams to sell. And I'm going to teach you the I noticed, I recommend framework. We're going to show you how you can rally your team and get them pumped about growing your company, making you more money. And we're also going to show you how you can make your team feel confident about making offers to their customers, even if they're shy, even if they've never sold anything to anybody before. In today's workshop, we're going to be giving you the strategies that we use to use video to train high-performing service teams that can sell. And we're going to give you the system that we use to do it almost on autopilot. So before we start, at the end of this workshop, we do have a special offer that we're going to make to you, but we only want you to buy it if this workshop is helpful for you, helpful for your business first. So I want you to judge us based on the quality of the content that you get here. Fair enough? Well, without further ado, I think we should introduce you to Eric. Eric is a home service expert. He's an author for home service businesses. He's a speaker. He trains over 600 home service teams, and he built and sold his service business for over eight figures. So, Eric, why don't you take the screen from here and you can get going?
All right. Connor, I think you're making me sound better than I am, but I appreciate it. I'll take it any day of the week.
Someone has to pay for you. Because you're not going to do it for yourself.
No, I'm not. So anyway, yeah, I just want to thank everybody for coming out. I really appreciate it. Oh, we got Jersey Mike coming in. Hold on, just let him in. Yeah, my name is Eric Sprague. For those who don't know me, Connor gave me a nice welcome. I've been in the home services space since I was 15 years old. Started cleaning swimming pools. We'll talk a little bit about that. I've done a bunch of jobs in home services, but
Hey, Eric, I'm sorry to interrupt you. We can't see your screen. Can you
well, then that's a problem.
yeah.
All
We gotta
right.
deal with this tech stuff.
Sorry, guys. I'm old and not good at this. Can you see
Good.
it
Take your
now?
time. You're doing just fine, man. Yep, you're
Yeah,
coming up
there we
now. Oh,
go.
buddy, what a face.
Okay. Yeah,
The
yeah.
face for radio.
That's right. Yeah. So anyway, yeah, I've been doing this a long time. I've had pretty much every single job that you can have in home services through the years since I was a kid. Worked up my way up to VP of operations at an eight-figure business. I was running all the technicians there. Went on my own, started a cleaning and restoration business. Larry and I sold that, it'll be 6 years ago in September. Now I'm doing business coaching, doing Super Tech University, which is video training. We'll talk a little bit about that. And then Larry and I have a podcast. So point being, I'm old and I've been around for a while, right? So that's hopefully if we've been around long enough, we learn something. And what we're going to do today is we're going to do really two parts. I'm going to do the foundational part, and then Connor's going to do the tactical part, and then I'll talk to you guys a little bit at the end too. But the goal is to help everybody sell, especially because a lot of us have technicians, but I have a few clients here that I'd like to celebrate, right? We have Paul and Tina on here, and I think we started, when we started working together, Paul, you guys can correct me, you're doing about 500,000. You did 2.8 within 3 years. So huge success. These guys have an amazing cleaning and restoration company. They're getting results because they do the work, right? Levi Gain, he's not here. Carpet cleaner, started with us doing 480, did 760 last year. We're on pace right now for 1 million. So he's getting results. And this is all based on being good at sales, right? And then Mike Johnson's here with Pioneer Restoration. They started working with me, well, probably about a year and a half ago. They're at 975. They did 1.5 in the first 9 months we were together, and they're on pace for 2.7 million. Kudos to you, Mike. Good job, man. Appreciate it. So the point being is that if we just implement the things that we learn, right, it's not always learning new things. It's a lot of times, like Connor said, it's implementing them. We will get results. And let me tell you what some of those things are. So I mentioned that I started my home service career, you know, what is this? 42 years ago at a pool service company. Now, most pool service companies only have a few people. It's kind of a chuck and a truck industry, right? They don't scale very much. But the company that I work for, Crispin Pool, the guy that owned it is an accountant, and he took the business in trade because the guy who owned it couldn't pay his bill. And then, so he had a very different mentality about how to run a service company. And they now have 55 vans and probably a good 70, 75 employees. So like, they are not your typical pool service company. And here's why, and then how it can affect all of us, right? So I started there. I'm 15 years old. I'm a kid, and I'm going to go service some of the highest end homes in probably the country along the coast of Maine. And Dick Crisman insisted that we have neat uniforms tucked in, looking good every single day. I've never cleaned my van more than at Crisman Pool. We had to clean our vans every single day before we left the shop. That was like not negotiable, because he wanted every one of his vans to look perfect when it rolled. Then he used to hand us 2 Ziploc bags before we'd roll out every day. And he called it the Leave It Better policy and the Lost and Found bag. So as most of you know, when you clean a swimming pool, there's like a little skimmer basket. And in that, you always find like pens and paper clips and a penny and all this. And his whole thing was to show how high end we are, to show how honest we were. We used to have to put that in a Ziploc bag, and at the end, go ring the doorbell and give them what we found in the skimmer bucket, like a penny or a paper clip, and just say, hey, I know you probably don't want these things, but we would never take your stuff off site. So here it is, right? Positive moment of truth for that client. The lost and found bag was, he was like, I don't ever want you to leave a job site without making it better than when you arrived. So I want you to find a cigarette butt that blew onto the lawn. I want you to find a rock that's out of place on the driveway, whatever. Put it in the bag and bring it back to me at the end of the day, right? So all of a sudden, we're being trained to give amazing service, right? What does amazing service do? It allows you to charge more, allows you to sell better. And then we used to role play. So here I am, 15, 16-year-old kid, learning how to go ring a doorbell, learning how to talk to a client, learning how to sell them something else, right? These were the things that separated us, because these are the kinds of places that we worked. Anybody know who lives here or lived here? Anybody throw out the chat? I used to clean the swimming pool when I was a kid. I know Eric Olson knows. He's seen this presentation before. but yeah, this is Walker's Point, and George Herbert Walker Bush was our client, right? Why are we getting clients like President Bush? Because we're doing all these other things. Do you think we're the lowest price option? No, we're the highest price option. And we were busy all of the time because we were doing all these little things that made selling easier, right? So, you know, let's take a step back. I think most of the people here are business owners or business managers on some level, right? And when we start our entrepreneurial journey, at least this certainly was for me, I dreamed of more money, more time off, more freedom, more vacations, financial stability. I think all of us dream of these things, right? These are the things that we want. We cannot have any of those things without a very healthy relationship with selling. We have to be able to sell our services, right? So sales starts between our ears. This is where most people in home services get tripped up. You can't sell at high prices unless you believe you deserve it. I cannot tell you how many people I have trained over the years who just didn't believe that they deserved the money. They didn't believe they deserve to price higher. They didn't believe that they deserve to have a great life like the clients that they were going to. But we do. We're doing amazing work. We're helping people. We're making their lives better, right? So sales starts with our money mindset and with our team's money mindset. You know, the owner of the business or the manager might have a great relationship with money, but do your team members who you ask to sell, what is their relationship with money? Do they feel that it's worth it? Do they feel that they can afford it? Do they feel that they deserve to give that price, right? We have to make sure that they understand you deserve to have money. You deserve to have a retirement. You deserve to have a vacation, a nice vacation. You should be able to own a home, right? These are the things that often in the home services space get overlooked. And we want to make sure that everybody is on this path. So sales really starts before we get into all the tactics and all this. If we don't have a good relationship with our own money or deserve that we can get more, then we need to work on that, right? I have a client, super talented individual, master of his craft, grew up in a household where the relationship with money was not great. And, you know, he started out at like $255 an hour. And, you know, he deserved more than $255 an hour, but he didn't believe that he did, right? His relationship with money, whatever, wherever that came from, was hindering him. And we have slowly worked on just that. How do you think? Now that person is at $435 an hour and still rising, doing the exact same work he was doing before, but now more confident in his ability to sell at a higher rate, and people are buying, and he has better clients because of it, right? Often the people who will pay the most are the easiest and best clients. Almost always, right? So what doesn't your client understand? They don't understand your services, whether you're a plumber, an HVAC tech, a restoration contractor, a carpet cleaner, it doesn't matter. They don't get like that. They just figure that all of us know how to do this work, right? So they figure if I call Rusty to clean my carpets, I figure just Rusty must know everything about carpet cleaning or else he wouldn't be in business. That may or may not be true, right, for any company. But here's what they do understand. They know how well we communicate with them, right? High prices are very hinged on how well we communicate with clients. Do we look trustworthy? Do we look them in the eye when we talk to people? Do our technicians look them in the eye, right? Do we seem excited to serve them? Do we smell good? And do we make them feel safe in their home? You can charge more for this. Right? You can't charge more for changing, you know, an angle stop on a toilet, right? It's kind of a commodity. It's going to be a similar price for most people. But if you can do all of these things, you can build that value where they're willing to pay more to have you come do that work, right? Ed Marchiselli, the SEAL, we'll talk more about him a little bit later. He said the greatest line ever. He said, it's always going to be about price until you make it not about price, right? It's always going to be for every client all about price until we add enough value doing other things to make them not care about the price because they like us so much they want us. That's where we need to get to, right? So we used to have, our company was called Shamrock, Larry and I, we had a program internally called GUTS. Grooming, uniforms, truck, and shop, right? We can't control the economy. We can't control whether the people are having a good day or a bad day. We can't control our competition. We can't control traffic. But you know what I can control? How well groomed my people are, what their uniforms look like, how good our trucks look, and how clean my shop is. We'll go through that real quick, right? And why that's important. So if I have this client, this is everybody's ideal client, I would assume, right? This person is not price sensitive. They want high quality. They're willing to spend money as long as we live up to their expectations. If I don't have my grooming, if my technicians don't look good, is that wealthy client really going to feel good about me? Probably not, right? So I need to come in looking sharp, looking good, you know, hair trimmed, or if it's longer, pulled back, trimmed beard, smelling good, uniform, looking the part, right? That way they're like, I made the right choice. I'm willing to pay for that, right? Uniforms. This is Any Hour Plumbing. They're here in Utah where I'm at. I mean, they have the nicest uniforms around. They have 1,400 employees. Everywhere you look around here, you're going to see an Any Hour Plumbing truck. There's a reason they have 1,400 employees, because they're doing it right. And they are, I use them. They are nowhere near the cheapest in town. Matter of fact, they're probably the most expensive, right? But they look the part. I want to have them in my house because I feel safe and secure with my family, with these young, mainly men in my home, because they look that part and they're working on it, right? You know, who gets paid more? Chucking a truck? Coming in the cutoff shirt, the jeans, and looking like he hasn't shaved in a year and all that? Or Paul the Pro, looking sharp, has a uniform, looks good. Now, Chuck might be the better technician. Let's assume he is. He still won't make as much money as Paul. I guarantee you those high-end clients will pay more money for that nice uniform, that clean-cut look, all those things. So even though Chuck is better at what he does, he's probably not going to be able to charge the same amount of money. And if we're going to sell, we want to get a lot of money for it, right? So next thing, trucks. I'm not saying you have to go see Dan Antonelli and pay, you know, whatever he charges for a full rebrand and all that. Just have your vans look good. Get your name on the van. Have it clean. All of those things. I mean, if you ask Tommy Mello, A1 Garage, he's doing well over 200 million now. He'll tell you that his logo and his van wraps are one of the most important marketing pieces in his company. We want to be rolling around looking good, right? There's a reason that most garage door companies have like one van or two vans, and Tommy Mello has like 20 locations, because he's looking the part. He's able to sell at a higher rate, right? And then here's my pet peeve, guys. I had to throw this in. This is more for me than anybody else. I hate dashboard trash. Like, if that person pulls up to my house and they're looking like this, I'm sending them home. My wife's sending them home, because why? If that's what your van looks like, what's my house going to look like? How are you going to serve me well if you can't even keep your own van clean? Right? So don't lose the dashboard game. Right, we want our vans or trucks looking good. And then the last thing is the shop, right? And everybody always asks me when I say this, like, Eric, why do we care about the shop? What's the shop? What's the matter with the shop? What's the difference? Because how we do one thing is how we do everything. If our shop looks like crap, if we're unorganized and we're rummaging around all the time, you don't think our team sees the disconnect there and they're not going to act that way at our clients' homes? Of course they are, right? So we need to keep our shop. I'm not saying it should look like, you know, the cleanest, neatest place ever. It needs to be organized. It needs to be clean. It needs to just be tidy. It needs to look good. Because what are we doing? We're setting an example for our team to go out and build this platform of professionalism so that we can sell at a higher rate, right? So that's the first step. The first step to selling at higher prices and selling more is to start with our brand. And make sure our brand looks great and acts great to the client. The next step is the theater of business. We need to put on a show when we get to those people's houses, right? So much of their buying emotion or their buying decisions are going to be about how we behave when we get there, right? That first impression that we make. You know, every job's a stage, and every tech is an actor or an actress, Right. We're putting on a show. The more theater that we can put on for that client, the more impressed they are, the more impressed they are, the more that they're going to want to go ahead and do business with us, hopefully at a higher ticket rate. Right. So what's that look like? I'll break it down real quick, like for Larry and I in our cleaning business or restoration, but it applies to any trade. The first thing we did is we started off with a pre-job call. Why did we do that? Because we want to set the tone before our technician even arrives. Hey, Mr. and Mrs. Jones, it's Eric with Shamrock. I'm leaving my current job. I'm heading your way. My GPS says I'm about 25 minutes away. Hey, by the way, I'm going to stop at a Starbucks and get a coffee on the way. Would you like anything? Why am I doing that? Because it's the law of reciprocity. If I offer them something, when I get there, they're going to want to give me something back, which is a job, right? So for a $5 cup of coffee, I could be buying myself a $1,500 job. That's part of the theater business. You know, I'm going to park out on the street. I'm not going to pull in the driveway because they might not want me to pull in the driveway. I'm going to practice with my team the interactions at the front door, just like I did when I was 15, 16 years old at Chrisman Pool. We're going to practice how to ring a doorbell, how to walk up to the job, how to identify yourself, how to talk to that client. These things matter. A little bit of training goes a very long way to raising it. Then we're going to teach inspection basics, educating the client before we sell it, right? So they know exactly what is going to happen. And then I'm very big on property protection, putting down, you know, runners or ram board or corner guards or whatever. There's a theater to that that the client loves. The more property protection we can put down and show the care for the house, the more they're going to value us. Mentioned Levi Gain earlier. You know, one of the things Levi and I have put together, and we did this at our company, was having an inspection sheet so that when you go to a house, you're asking that client. This is a great way to teach technicians to sell without having it feel so scary to them, right? Because so a lot of technicians like to do technical work, but they don't like the idea of sales, right? Well, create a system for them to like sales more, make it easier, right? So we created this thing where we would ask the client, hey, do you mind if I go around and check all of these things in your house? Connor's going to get into this a little bit more in a minute. Check all of these things, and then I'm going to report back to you what kind of condition they're in and what we can do to fix it, right? Very easy way to bring up topics of conversation regarding sales with a client, right? So we're going to do that inspection sheet. We're going to role play. We're going to practice with our team. Like, how are we expecting people to just, who are technically minded, if we want add-on sales, to just go out and miraculously be good at it if we don't train them? I mean, we train them to do all the technical stuff. Why wouldn't we train them to do this as well? Scripting presentations, having bullet points that they're practicing so they say the right things at the right times. And then using a CRM to set frequency awarenesses. If you have the type of work where you go time and time again, you say, hey, Mr. and Mrs. Jones, I noticed that we haven't worked on this part of your house in the last 4 years. If you like to talk about that, right? So we're using a system as a way to get our technicians, especially, and estimators to sell more, right? The more we can systemize it, the better. Anybody have any questions so far? I know I'm moving quick because I want to try to get as much in an hour as I can. No, everybody good? No questions? All right, we're going to keep going. All right, well, I'm going to turn it over to Connor. Now, I know you're seeing Connor and you're going, Connor looks really young, right? Like, is Connor have anything to tell me, right? But here's the deal, guys. Connor might be young in years, but Connor is also very experienced. He's been working in his parent, they have a pest control company and a window washing company. And Connor, as you can see in this picture, I think was like 7 or 8 years old here, right? Connor's been doing this work a long time, and Connor's a super smart guy. So I want Connor to talk about some of the tactics that they use at their company that Larry and I used at ours. So Connor, you know, he's done it all. He's window wash, he's pressure wash, he's done pest control. You can see him there cleaning a boathouse. That actually looks kind of fun, Connor. Looks like a good time. And there he is with his dad, Denver, and their team out, you know, doing the pest control. And is that at a parade, Connor? You at a parade?
That's a parade, yeah.
Yeah, there you go. It looks like a parade with a balloon. So Connor's been an assistant tech when he was a kid. Then he moved to lead technician, ops manager, territory manager, which means sales manager at most places, right? He's training home service teams. He also does SEO work and a bunch of different marketing stuff with not only us, but other people. That's Darren Smith. He's in the UK. And, you know, a while ago, Connor was telling me about the framework that he uses, and I want to turn it over to Connor. So, Connor, why don't you go ahead and take it from here?
All right, sounds good. Okay. So far, a really, really big part of this has been the structure, the foundation of what's required before we can get our teams to ethically sell for us. And so that's what the first part was. Eric really spent a lot of time on that, and it's because it's important. But now that that's been covered, I feel confident that we can dive into the tactics. And really, I want to go over four things while we're here today. I want to talk about how add-on sales can double the profits of a job site. I want to talk about finding opportunity in your customer's home. I'm going to show you what I call the I noticed, I recommend framework. And then I'm going to show you how we can turn your technicians into a high-performing sales team as well. But I think we should start with the very, very beginning. The definition. So Investopedia says that an add-on sale is an additional item sold to a buyer of a main product or service. Now, Investopedia has done a really good job at making this sound horribly boring. And so in the time that we've got together, I want to show you that the add-on sale is not horribly boring. It's actually one of the most exciting sales that we can make. And they're used all over the world in so many different industries. They're used at the checkout at grocery stores. Amazon is the king of the add-on sale. They'll always show you other stuff that you might like as well. Like if I buy a bike helmet, they're going to show me other bike-related stuff. Fast food is really good at this. Would you like to make that a combo? Would you like fries with that? Starbucks started saying, "What can I get you to eat?" And food has become a powerful add-on sale. But the thing is that as home service business owners, we have a couple really distinct advantages. And our add-on sales are more powerful than every other industry. It's because we've got three things going for us. We've got a higher ticket value, right? We're not selling $10, $30 things. We're selling a couple hundred, a couple thousand. Some of us are even into the tens of thousands of dollars of value that we're selling. We've got higher profit margin in general than other types of businesses. And with the right process, we have a really high closing rate as well. Add-on sales are really, really profitable, and this is really important to understand because you've already spent the money on gas, vehicles, insurance, your building if you have one, and it actually costs you very little to deliver additional services. And this means that every additional service that you can sell, most of that drops straight to your profit lines, and that's how this can be so powerful. And then I'm going to show you with the right process, they can be the easiest sale to make as well. And that brings us to the I noticed, I recommend framework. This is the three-step framework that I teach all of my technicians for how to sell in the home in a way that feels good, in a way that isn't slimy. And the reason it works so well is because it's simple. It's three steps. It's low pressure. It's not slimy or sleazy, but it works really, really well. And so I want to introduce you guys to Brittany. Brittany is one of my technicians, and she came to us straight out of high school. She had never sold anything to anybody before. And so one day she was on a job site and she gives me a call and she says, "You know, Connor, I was up on my customer's roof. I noticed that her gutters are full, but I don't know how to present that to her. How do I show her that?" And so at that moment, I realized that I hadn't shown her this and I had failed her. So over the next 5 minutes, I walked her through the framework that I'm about to show you. And on her very first try, she went and closed a $380 deal on her very first try. Now, for some of you, 380 might sound like chump change. For some of you, 380 might sound very high. The point is, this framework works, and I've had it work for really expensive stuff. I've had it work for really cheap stuff as well. And so I'm going to walk you through the three steps. The first step is we got to get our team to look for opportunities in our customer's home. So when we're talking about finding opportunity, we got to realize and we got to get our teams to realize that opportunity is everywhere. Our customers' homes, they're generally pretty large. They're generally pretty nice. They require lots of maintenance, lots of work, lots of care. And in most cases, our customers work really hard outside of their home. And when they come home, they just want to come home to a place that's nice, it's clean, it's maintained, right? They don't want to take their Saturday to take care of their house. Like if I were to bet, I would bet that the owner of this home in this picture is not the one cleaning it. They're not the one doing the electrical or the plumbing. They're not piling that nice little mulch pile around the tree. They hire other people to do that. And so now that we've really got to get our team to start looking for opportunity in our customer's home, we have to ask the questions, what services make good add-ons? Because not all services are created equal. Good add-ons have four things. They've got to make your client's life easier, maybe save them some stress, maybe save them some money in the long run. You've got to have the required tools and parts in your vehicles to deliver that service. It's got to be high margin, right? Profitable, cost you a little bit to do it. You can sell it for a large amount of money. And it's got to be completed today. We got to do it while we're on the site. And so I'm going to walk you through this system for finding your best, your prime add-on services that you already sell. So this is your chance. Get out a notepad, get out a pen, maybe a highlighter. I'm going to walk you through this exercise because it's going to show you your most profitable add-on services without having to add any additional services to your service list. So the first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to want to list out all of the services that we offer. So like Eric said, I come from a window cleaning and gutter cleaning background, pressure washing, a little bit of pest control. So what I did is I listed all the services that we offered. So we got outside window cleaning, inside window cleaning, gutter cleaning, pressure washing, graffiti removal, light fixture dusting, scratch glass repair, and post-construction glass cleanup. So I want you to do this for yourself. I want you to list out all of your services that you offer. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to cross out the ones that need extra parts and the ones that need extra tools. So for me, in my example, I had to cross out pressure washing because my teams don't carry a pressure washer with them all the time. I had to cross out graffiti removal because my teams don't bring those chemicals with them. And I had to cross out scratch glass repair because they don't bring that equipment with them either. Once we've crossed out the ones that need extra parts and tools, it's step three. We just got to highlight the ones that are the most profitable. They cost us the least to deliver. We can charge the most for them. And that left me with three: outside window cleaning, gutter cleaning, and light fixture dusting. So you're going to be left with a handful, maybe two, maybe five, maybe a little bit more, but you're going to be left with a handful of your prime add-on services. And so now what you're going to get your team to do is you're going to get your team to start looking for your prime add-on services. So instead of getting your team to look for a laundry list of 40, 50, 60 different things that they could do, you get them to focus on the ones that are your prime ones, the ones that cost you the least, that you can make the most money on. If I were to do an analysis of the add-on sales that my team does, if we were to break it down, the vast majority would be these top three, these prime add-ons. And so that's the first part. We got to get our team looking around, head on a swivel, noticing opportunity while they're in the customer's home. And so now we got to move into kind of setting up the sale, which is step number two. When your team recognizes an opportunity where you can help your customer in their home, you're going to get them to take a picture or a video. Just get your team to pull out a smartphone or some kind of device, take a picture or a video. And I know this step seems really simple, but it's so important to not skip this step because skipping this step just burns trust. This step increases your closing rate by building trust because you're going to take out your phone and you're going to show the picture or video to the customer. And they're going to see that you're not actually just creating fake problems. You're actually pointing out real problems that you can solve. So that's why this step is so important. That's step two. Then it is time to sell with this third step. And I made this slide really nice and bright because the next slide has the two most profitable sentences that I found so far. And so I just wanted to give you a chance to take a picture of it before we rip past it. So that's your warning. And this is the script that I get my team to close the deal. It goes like this. While I was walking around your home, I noticed that, then you tell them what you noticed. Is that something that you would like us to do while we are here? Or would you prefer to do it yourself? And then you show your customer the picture or the video of the problem that you took. So I'm going to say that again. While I was walking around your home, I noticed that. You tell them what you noticed. Is that something that you would like us to do while we are here? Or would you prefer to do it yourself? And then once again, you show them the picture that you took. Now, this is so powerful because it gives your customer a choice. Would you like us to do it while we're here? This option is easy. It's done today. They don't have to spend a weekend worrying about it. And then they have option two. Would you prefer to do it yourself? This one takes time. This one isn't done today. This one takes other time that they could be spending doing things that they want to do. And so the choice is pretty easy in most cases for a lot of our customers. They pick the one that's done today. And so that's the I noticed, I recommend framework. This is the framework that I use to get my team to close deals on site. This works for male and female technicians, young and old technicians. This works for technicians who are terrified of selling because it's not confrontational, it's consultation selling. And that's why it's so powerful, because it's so simple and it works so well. And I want to show you exactly how well this works. So I'm going to show you two job sites and how an add-on sale can affect profits. So we're going to start with job site one. We're going to take a $300 ticket. We are not going to have an add-on sale. We're going to pay out our team because we got to get our team to deliver the services, $75. But we all know we have other expenses as well. We've got to pay for our building and our insurance and our sales commission and all of that many other stuff. So when all is said and done, we're left with about $60 in take-home profit. Now, for you math wizards, that's about 20%, and that's not horrible. It's not bad, but we can do a lot better. Because with job site two, we take that same $300 ticket. This time, we get our team to sell one measly little $100 add-on service. This one tiny little service, super easy to close on site. Now we're going to pay out our team a little bit more because we're going to give them an incentive to sell. So instead of 75, we're going to pay out 100. And here's where the magic happens. Our overhead and our sales commission does not change. It stays the same. So what does that do for our profits? In example one, we had a $60 profit. In example two, we had a $135 profit. That one tiny little $100 add-on sale made that job site 2.25 times as profitable. This is one of the most powerful levers that we can pull for profits and services while building a deeper relationship with our customers and helping them at a deeper level. And so I want you to ask yourself, what happens to profits when you take a $370 job, you turn it into a $540 job? What happens when you take a $3,100 job and you can turn it into a $3,500 job? What happens when your team starts with a $360 job and they add on sale of $506? Well, in this case, the customer was so happy that our team pointed out a problem that they could solve that not only did they leave them a review, they also left them a tip. They thanked them with a tip for almost tripling the job size. When my team found that out, they were super excited and they also were super eager to go help their next customer because it actually makes our customers' lives better. And when we can do this, we become unstoppable. We make more money on each job site than our competitors. We make more money to take home for our lives. We can take better care of our team and all of those wonderful things that we want to do. Now, you might be thinking, you know, this sounds great, at least in theory, but I'm never actually going to get my technicians to do this. And so that's what I want to talk about next. I want to talk about getting your team on board, excited about growing your business, making sales for your company. And so what I've noticed, and this is just my experience here, but there are two key points to getting a team on board and excited about growing the company. Step one is daily video drip training. We'll break that down. And then step two is overcoming objections. We'll break that down as well. Let's start with daily video drip training. Now, daily video drip training is this really simple concept where you create a short video for your team every single day that covers training topics like dealing with the customer, introducing yourself, sales in the home, those sorts of things. And then you have your team sit down, you have them watch it. Now, daily video drip training is absolutely fantastic because it really does three things. It daily encourages your team to do additional sales in the home. It helps build a community with your team because they're all learning the same thing at the same time together. And possibly most importantly, it sets a standard for your team and it acts as that reminder because people need to be reminded more than they need to be taught. I really, really love this quote because it is so true. Deep down, your team probably knows what is expected of them, but they just need that reminder, and they probably need the reminder more than you think they do. Because it really is true, people need to be reminded more than they need to be taught. And so that's why Eric and Larry made SuperTech University. SuperTech University is the ultimate training tool for home service businesses. What they do is they create short 3 to 5 minute videos for your team, and it's daily micro learning. It's short, it's digestible, it doesn't take a lot of time out of your day. But these trainings cover things like personal development and how your team can build their life's goals and dreams inside of your company. It covers topics like job site behavior and giving our customers truly five-star experience. And it's even got trainings for your customer service reps and the people that answer the phone, because they're the first voice that our customers hear. So I don't want to spend a lot of time here. If that interests you, they got packages ranging between $247 and $697, depending on what you're looking for. You can go to supertechu.com. But I also want to show you how you can do it yourself, because I understand that while SuperTechU is really powerful, you may not be in a place right now where SuperTechU is the perfect fit for you. So I want to show you how you can use SuperTechU, or not SuperTechU. I want to show you how you can use daily video drip training for yourself. It's going to take some time, but the investment is well worth it. Step number one, you're going to set up your studio. Keep it really simple. Smartphone, tripod, some kind of light. I wanted to include this picture here because I want to show you that when you first get started, it doesn't have to be fancy. This is one of Eric's first studios, and I want you to see the exposed.
Yeah, I was going to say, Connor, I'm not working out of there anymore.
I know. Yeah, it's one of your old ones, one of the first ones that you did.
Yeah.
I included this picture because I wanted to show that it doesn't have to be fancy when you first get started, right? Like, you can see that this is not a fancy place, and obviously Eric made it more Hollywood as he went on. But when you first get started, it doesn't have to be complex. And once you're done setting up your studio, you're just going to write out training content. And this is where probably the bulk of the work is. Now, I'm not going to let this video scroll all the way through, but this is one of Eric's lessons planners for his teams. And you're going to notice you can steal this format. You're going to notice there is a lesson title that he covers here. And then there is the short script that he wrote over here as well. And so I'm not going to spend a lot of time there, but you can feel free, copy this format for your planning, for your training, for your teams. And then step three, by far the easiest step, you just set aside 5 minutes in the morning with your team. You can do it in person like this team, or you can do it on Zoom. We have people who do it successfully in both ways. And so you can expect this to take some time. It takes between 2 and 5 hours a week. But what you're going to notice is that the return that you're going to get from your crews is going to pay you back for that time and then some. You're probably going to notice that your crews are going to be more engaged. They're going to be more effective on the job site. They're going to be more inclined to do additional sales. All of these many benefits that you can get from daily video drip training. Chris Longo says this, I can tell you this, the best thing I ever did for my company is to have morning meetings. And so that's step one, daily video drip training. The second step to getting your team on board and excited about making sales for your company is overcoming their objections. Now, when we were first implementing add-on sales into the businesses that I've been involved in, my team really had three major objections. It's very likely that your team is going to have these three objections as well. So I want to show you kind of how we broke through these. The first objection, I don't want to add work to my day. On the surface, fair enough. Who wants to add more work to their day for nothing? So what they're really saying is, what's in it for me? So that's totally different. Now, instead of having them say, I don't want to add work to my day, we have to ask the question, how can add-ons benefit my team? And so there are a couple things you can do. First, give them a bonus when they sell an add-on sale. That's huge. You can hold contests between your crews. Crew A is crushing it this week. Crew B is absolutely leading in sales this month. And maybe congratulate your team when they offer an add-on, whether it closes or not. Because I promise you, if you can get your team to start making offers to their customers, they're going to start closing, and they're going to start closing quite a bit. The next objection your team might have, I don't want to be a slimy salesman. Also fair enough, right? Nobody does. When we dug deep and we started asking our teams more questions, we found out that they were really saying, I only want to sell services that our clients need. And this is a totally different objection, but they weren't voicing it. They only want to sell services that our clients need. Now, I hope every single one of you sells services that make your client's life better, because if you sell crap, that sucks to be you. We have to ask the question, how do add-ons help our customers? And we have to get our team to realize that add-ons make our customers' lives better. So as soon as my team realized that not showing a customer a problem is actively hurting them, they realized that they need to start showing customers a problem in their place that they can take care of. So for me, like I said, I come from a window cleaning, gutter cleaning, pressure washing background. And so when my teams would notice that their customers' gutters were full, if they chose to ignore it and not tell their customer, they were actively allowing mold to build up, maybe damage the house, maybe get inside, cause breathing issues. All of these many things, they were actively hurting their customers, right? Like, that makes sense, right? Then you got daily video drip training, consistent reminders that helps our team realize that add-ons make their customers' lives better. And then you can further reinforce that by showing them every single review that they get. Whenever a team makes an add-on sale and gets a five-star review, they're going to be super excited to go and help their next customer even more. And then the third objection that I want to cover, your team might say, I can't do it. And this is the most real out of all of them, because they can't do it. Really, what they're saying is, I don't know how to do it because I've never done it before. So we got to make our team feel confident. And this is probably the biggest hurdle to get over this. You got to give them a consistent system. The I noticed, I recommend framework doesn't change, because those three steps are such a consistent and effective system. Again, you can use daily video training to give them confidence, boost that confidence, but really keep it simple. The I noticed, I recommend framework is three steps. Notice the opportunity in the customer's home, document it for the customer, two sentences to close the deal. That's it. It's super straightforward. If you can answer these three questions, your team's going to be excited about offering add-ons to their customers. They're going to be excited about making sales for your business. They're going to be excited about their new opportunity to make some extra money by making sales for your business. And it's just such a virtuous cycle that it helps your customers, it helps your team, it helps you. And so those are the two steps: daily video drip training and overcoming their objections. And that's all the tactics that I've got for you. I'm going to pass it back to Eric here. Eric, you want to take the screen back?
Yeah, I will. Oops, does it's not
very, letting very me good.
All right, let me. Connor, it's not. Oh yeah, sorry. Again, I'm not great at this. So hold on. All right, do you guys see the screen? Everybody sees it. All right. Does anybody have before Connor? Good job,
hold on,
man.
Eric, I'm not seeing your screen here.
No,
there it
no,
is.
No, I see
there.
It. Yeah, okay. It's all good. Okay.
All right. Before I move on, Connor, good job. Anybody have any questions about the tactics part that Connor was talking about? Throw it in. I can be happy to address any of that stuff. Mike, you got a question? Go ahead. Mike Johnson.
Here we go. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, hear you fine.
Yeah. Hey, so I missed. Okay, I missed that last part. So on the steps to identify profitable line items to try and add on. So the first was to make a list of all the services, all the line items, basically. Then
that's
cross
correct.
Out the services that require extra equipment that are not on the truck daily, and then highlight something. What
highlight
was that?
Highlight the ones that are the most profitable to you. Right,
oh,
so
you've
got some services that you don't make a whole lot of money on. You want to sell the ones that make you the most money.
Okay, thanks.
Awesome.
My pleasure.
I'm going to mute you, Mike. All right. Anybody else got any questions? Jersey Mike. What's up, buddy?
Oh, I think you're muted.
We can't hear you, Mike. You're muted. All right. We'll come back to you. You could call me or text me if you, I can answer it, or Connor. Okay. All right. Well, look, I don't want to take everybody's whole day, and I don't want to go way over, but I do want to, like, look, we're doing a sales webinar, so I'm gonna sell something too, right? So that's part of it. I'd be kind of disingenuous if I didn't. So I want to talk about something that we're gonna offer. It's got a lot of cool bonuses too, but I want to get into, we're gonna do a 6-week home service sales system. Look, we only had an hour and we were flying, and I know that's not in depth enough to like build something off. So we want to add to that, right? So we're going to do 6-week pre-recorded class for everybody. Week one, get the phone ringing, because if you can't get the phone ringing, you don't have anything to sell, right? We got to get to people's houses. We got to get in front of them. Number two, we got to book the appointment. Whoever is your CSR or receptionist, we need to make sure that when that phone call comes in, that person can actually get somebody to the potential sale so that we can make that, right? Three, a service sales system, detailed more than today, breaking down. These are all the steps that we do to make sales, especially if you have like a professional estimator or bidding person or whatever you guys call it. It depends. Comfort advisor, like an HVAC. Week four, stress-free systems. Look, systems for sales are crucial because people who aren't naturally good at sales need a system to do it. We need to make sure they have a system to work by, right? Killing your callbacks. Connor was talking about, you saw how much profit you make when you make an add-on sale. Well, you can wipe all that profit out and then some with one callback, right? We do not want to be going back. It's the biggest killer of profit ever. And then lastly, no more competition. We got to have a system to keep our clients forever, right? We don't want to spend, you know, $100, $200 or whatever it is on acquisition to get a client through like SEO and then only clean for them once because or do whatever for once, because we're going to make our money on that lifetime value of that client, not that transaction, right? So we're offering this for $997. There's 5 spots open and you'll see why in a second. And think about it. And look, you're going to get a lot more than that. I got bonuses, right? So hold on. But that's just like 1 or 2 sales will pay for this. Like if you just get, you can get one of your people to do a sale or two more, you're paying for this immediately, right? But wait, there's more, right? There's always more. So you're going to get that. You're going to get the recording of those classes. They're really cool. Then Connor talked about Super Tech, and you saw that it's like 2 to 5 hours a week. For me, it's even more than that, right? This picture is, does anybody know Kevin Bunce? I got some cleaners and restorers in here. So Kevin is his, to my knowledge, Larry, correct me if I'm wrong, they have never missed a morning Super Tech lesson in 4 years, not once. And when they started with us, they had 12 employees. They have over 75 employees now and sold out to a private equity company. And yet they're still every day doing those lessons. And Kevin's whole point is like, I don't have time to do it, so I outsource it to you. So everybody here is going to get this. Ryan Harrington says, I highly recommend them to anyone and everyone looking to be their best on and off the field. Ray Corin, kind of can't express how fortunate we are to have Super Tech as an integral part of our team. From the very beginning, Super Tech has proven to be a game changer for us. We have a lot of stories like that, right? I'm proud of Super Tech University, so I'll brag about it a little bit, I guess. But as Connor said, we have 3 packages. The highest package is $697 a month. And then what we're going to do is if you buy the 6-week course, we're going to give you that for 6 months, right? So that's daily tech. Now, if you already have a Super Tech University membership, we're going to upgrade you to all of it, to the premium, because I know there are clients here that already have that. You will get that. If you do have the premium, then we'll talk and we'll add some more value to you. But that's $697 a month times 6 months. So that's a value of $4,182. On the retail market, right? So this one bonus is worth 4 times the price of what we're selling today, just this alone, right? So you're going to get the recording of the classes. You're going to get the Super Tech bonus, right? Huge. Next bonus, full team training. So in Super Tech, you're going to get CSR training or receptionist, depending on the industry and what you call it, technician training, service manager leadership training. Because look, anybody other than me ever made the mistake of taking their best technician and making them the service manager when they had no training to be a service manager, and then it blows up in their face. I've done that more than once, right? It doesn't work. If we're going to move somebody along who's a great technician, but now all of a sudden we're changing their job description to become a leader, they need training in that area. We have training for that. And then we have sales training as well. So that's what, and everybody in your team, like we can get their email, they can all get these lessons and you can train your whole team, not just one person, right? So you're going to get the 6 classes, super tech, and then the full team training. Bonus 3, group coaching. So Larry and I have a group that meets weekly. We're going to add 6 weeks on. So if you want live coaching that we do every week in the group, you'll get that. That's as a value for the 6 weeks at $375. So you're more than welcome to come. If you can't come at that time, we can always send you the recordings of those too. We can, it's a varied group of topics in that class. So it's not always just sales. It's also just running a better service business, right? So then you're going to get all 3 of those things. And here's the last one. This is the one that I find most exciting because I like to share where I live, right? The best bonus is an invitation here to Ogden, Utah to do a 2-day intensive training at no charge. It would be included in the $997, right? So you come out here. If nobody's been to Ogden, Utah before, it's a mecca for cool sports. It's a nice town. It's in the mountains. There's golf, there's skiing, there's hiking, there's fishing, there's four-wheeling. There's like everything that you could possibly want to do here, especially for outdoors. And this is what we do. We sit down and we do deep work. I'll show you some pictures in a second, but basically we take a very small group. We sit at a conference table. I've created a 70-plus page workbook with skills assessments. Katie Harris from Spot On Solutions, if anybody's in the restoration space, they probably know Katie. She comes down, right? And she spends a half day doing digital marketing training for you guys. We talk about hiring, onboarding, and creating a high performance team, right? We just did one recently, and it's nice because we just sat down and we did deep work on ourselves and on our company, right? So normally, if somebody's going to come out here and spend 2 days with me, it's going to be $3,000, but that's going to be included as well. Here's a picture of our last class. There's Katie teaching the digital marketing. There is 12 people in this class, and we cap those classes at 12 because we want to be able to have a cool experience, right? And we're just sitting in our offices here, making sure everybody's well taken care of. Mike, you were there. You want to, real quick, not long, give us what you guys got out of that and what you felt that experience was? There's Mike in the hat right there, flannel shirt. Mike came to Utah from Alaska in a flannel shirt. It was 103 degrees.
I'm going to dress differently next time, I promise.
Yeah, good for you.
I'm actually adding the notes from today to the binder that we used during those 2 days. It was awesome. I was flipping back through here at the assessments and some of the conversations that we had. It was really great to get, just to kind of open up about some of the realities of where our business has been, where it is now, and where we want to go. There were other business owners and managers there who have been in our same situation or want to be in the situation and had good insight into how to handle where we're at and how to get to the next level. It was great. It was great. Thanks.
Yeah, good. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. So yeah, we're going to sit down and do some work. And then you can see here, this is DJ, one of the guys. He's Mike's business partner, Billy, came in on a 3-wheeler and they were all driving it around. And look, it's also kind of a nice vacation. You can stay an extra day or two and go do some fun stuff around here. So, DJ said, this is the best business retreat I've ever been to in my life. I can't tell you the number of breakthroughs that we've had here at this event. We're so grateful for the opportunity to come here. Levi, who we mentioned earlier, the quality of the people in the group and the way the lessons have been done has been excellent. Now we're truly on the road to 7 figures. Eric and Mandy, Ken and Mel are here somewhere. I think they are anyway. Since some of the biggest nuggets I received were from the other businesses here, right? That's one of the things. It's not about me and Katie, it's about getting with other business owners and getting ideas and starting friendships, right? Being able to collaborate was huge. So the next retreat is October 31st and November 1st. There aren't that many seats. So, you know, if you're thinking of signing up, then sign up soon. We're going to cap it at 12. We're selling only five here today because we already have some people in that class. If for some reason you can't make those two dates, we're going to have other dates and you would just be eligible for those when you could do it. If you like to ski, might want to come in the winter. So skiing's good here and I'll go skiing with you. So anyway, you know, basically for $9.97, you're getting super tech, you're getting full access for the whole team, you're getting 6 weeks of group coaching, and you're getting an invitation to come to Ogden and spend a couple of days with us. And we will, I can promise you, we will give you a lot of value for $9.97, especially if you come out here and spend a couple of days with us. And then we have a 30-day guarantee. No questions asked. For any reason you don't like it or you don't think it's what you want, we'll just give you your money back. No questions asked. We've had people that just felt it wasn't for them and we just cut them a check and send it right back. We're not here to take anybody's money. We want to add value and make sure that everybody is feeling like they're being taken care of, right? So if you add all that together, the street value of that $75.57, it's $9.97. There's five slots open today. And all you got to do is go to that QR code and you can sign up or have Larry send it to you, or Larry could put a link in the chat, whatever you guys want. And look, we want to help people. Larry and I have been very blessed in our life. We had a lot of people help us get to where we were. We sold. We feel like we need to give back. Yes, we still have a business. Yes, we're going to ask you for some money. But at the same time, we're going to try to deliver so much more value to you than we're ever taking in. That's what our real goal is. So anyway, guys, I don't want to take your whole day. We're 10 minutes over, but I wanted to share that